Welcome back. This is Arise News. You're watching The Morning Show with me, Biola Labi. When it comes to eating right, food is not just a simple choice of choosing vegetables over donuts. You need to get the right types of foods at the right time of the day. Joining me to tell us what we need to know about eating right is Dr. Chinaza Amadi, a medical doctor, certified coach, and nutritionist. Dr. Amadi, welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's great to have you. Thank you very much.
So I'm going to dig in because we're halfway through the year. Mm-hmm. Towards the end of last year, we did a show talking about nutrition, talking about fitness and wellness. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of people are doing a check-in now to say, wow, I've lost 6 months. I haven't done anything. Why start now? What is your advice to people that are like, have given up on themselves because they haven't fulfilled their goal?
You see, the best time to start anything is actually now. That's the best time. So if you keep waiting for tomorrow, and you see the thing, a lot of people make New Year resolutions mm-hmm. as per fitness-wise, as per what they want to lose weight. But the thing is, most people are not making resolutions that are affordable, are sustainable, and are actually achievable. Mm. You tell yourself, oh, before February, I'm going to lose 20 kg. And then at the end of February, you've lost 2 kg. That's very demoralizing. You just literally fall off. Or you decide, oh, I want to go on a no-carb diet or just only protein diet. You're not a fish farmer. You're not a poultry farmer. And you want to be eating only poultry or only fish. It doesn't make so much sense. You understand? You're doing something that's not affordable, something that's not always available to you. So that makes it not sustainable. Mm. So you can't sustain that lifestyle. Mm. I always tell people, when you want to lose weight, when you want to embark on that journey, sit down and look at your pocket size. Look at what is available to you. Look at what can I do. Don't look at the other person. It's an individual race.
So talking about budget, so I love the idea that you're talking about affordable and budget. One of the things that's very discouraging about eating healthy is that you have to buy expensive food, you have to buy salads, you have to buy dressing. It takes so much time to prepare. What is your advice? I mean, how do we eat well within our budget?
First of all, it's because the budget is different for different people. Mm-hmm. So if you're like the regular, typical, very budget-friendly Nigerian and you're like, you really do want to go on this journey, you go for fruits in season.
Okay.
First of all, go for foods in season. There's a period of time when yams are like, one yam is like 1,500. There's a time when one yam is 500 naira. Do you understand?
Okay,
there are different times. So at that time when it's really available, go for it.
But then people don't believe you can eat yam when you're on a diet.
Your
book here, Eat to Lose Weight, you're holding up a yam.
And very
traditional. I can figure out, is this for exercise?
Both for exercise, and after that, you roast it and eat it.
You use it to exercise, you roast it. Mm-hmm, okay. Mm-hmm. So it's all in one.
Yes, it's all in one. You see, the thing is, that's the thing. We keep looking outside. Mm. We have to look at what we're used to. You have to do what you're used to. If you're not used to a particular lifestyle, I can't eat salads every day because I'm very typical traditional. Mm-hmm. And I want my swallow. I want to have some yam sometimes. I want to eat my jollof, you know, the bottom pot jollof. You know, I want to eat something, you know, that's what you tell me to do something, just salad when I'm not white. No, I won't sustain that lifestyle. So the thing is, that's why I wrote this book about you have to learn to eat what we have, what you're used to. So you don't change so much. You won't miss so much. But then it's how are you eating it? That is where the whole thing comes into play. The budget thing is about eating what is available, and then how are you even eating that thing that is available?
All right, so let's take someone that has maybe a naira a day that they want to, and they want to eat healthy. They're going to tell you that the easiest thing for me to do is probably eat rice in the morning, rice in the afternoon, and maybe even forget dinner.
Yeah.
What's your advice to them? Like, how do we break that up? Let's even say you have 500 per meal, 500 naira.
If you have 500 naira per meal, with 500 naira, you can actually make okra soup.
Okay.
And eba.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I tell you, if it's so expensive, where you are, change your market and go shop another place.
Okay.
Shop where you can afford. Don't go where you can afford, because you can actually cook like 300 naira okra, like, in my area, you can actually get 300 naira okra, and you can get 100 naira crayfish. If you can't eat fish, eat crayfish. All of them are seafood. Mm. If you can't eat chicken, just buy one egg and put it in the center. It looks like all of them are still poultry. Mm-hmm. You understand? So it's you have to balance. Then you get one cup of eba. That's 500 naira. You don't have to finish it at the particular time you're sitting down. You understand? You can actually split it in two, and the soup will remain for the next day.
Mm. So basically, I mean, but what about portions? I mean, when we're eating eba, when we're eating pounded yam, how much are we supposed to eat?
You see, it's different for different people.
Okay.
And it depends on your goals, what you're looking for. I always tell people to, your portion is key. How much are you eating is very important. So I always recommend to people that you go for your baking cups, you know, the baking cups.
Yes.
That is standard worldwide.
Yes.
So always measure out your food so that you have, don't use your eye to eat. Most times, if you're very hungry, your eye would think that, oh, I need to finish this pot of food.
But I know what one cup looks like.
No, it's actually big.
Really?
Yes. Trust me.
Mm.
Yes.
All right.
It's really big.
I will measure my...
After cooking.
Yes.
Measure it out.
So after cooking, you measure the pounded yam before you eat it.
Yes. As in scoop it out.
Yes.
Yes.
And then put it in the cup.
In the cup and, put on your plate. You will see it's actually a
extra
lot.
Extra steps.
It's not so much. It's just like you're dishing out. Mm-hmm. But instead of dishing out with the regular, you know, the thing for dishing out the swallow, you now use your cup and just... And into your plate. It's like that's your serving spoon, literally.
So how did you find, I mean, for you, for when you look at your weight journey, how did you find Nigerian food working with you on your, when you were trying to lose weight?
When I first lost weight, I wasn't in Nigeria.
Okay.
So it was a lot easier.
Okay,
you know, chicken is very cheap.
Yes.
Salads are very available.
Yes.
But when I came back home, it was like so hard to acclimatize and so hard to adjust. But then I realized that you have to actually use what is around you and learn on those portions. Nobody said eba has to be dinner at 9 o'clock.
So, I mean, just so that people at home understand your journey, you used to weigh, how much did you weigh at one point?
Oh, at 16, I was already weighing 80 kg.
So at 16, so you grew up actually battling weight.
Yes, yeah, I grew up where those kind of people that you say, oh, you're big in your family.
You're big boned.
We're big boned.
I was asking you earlier that do you believe in people actually having bigger bones than normal?
No, because I was 80 kg at 16 years, and I'd lost, by the time I was 25, I'd lost almost 60, I'd got to 69 kg.
Wow.
And I realized that I could actually go that down. It's just that I looked sickly. So I tell people that it's different for different people.
Mm.
You understand? Some people, 69, they still look obese or something.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, 69 wasn't good. So I had to find my own healthy
zone
and my own happy zone and stay there.
Mm.
And that's where I am now. You understand?
So when your clients come in, especially young kids, and they think like sort of, this is just who I am, how do you advise people and how do you get people out of their own head in saying that you can achieve your weight goals? Because losing weight, it's like climbing Kilimanjaro.
True.
It's a lot of work.
It's actually a lot of work. I don't know how to sugarcoat it. I always tell you, it's hard.
Mm.
It's one of the hardest thing ever.
Mm.
But it's all about what do you want?
Mm.
What do you want this for? Do you want to be healthy? Do you want, by the time you're 45, you can't run around, chase your kids because your knees are aching you? Do you want to be able to climb the staircase and you're not panting so hard after the first floor because you can't catch your breath? Or do you want to be able to dance and boogie at 70?
Mm.
What do you want in the long term? So when you want to know what you want, you now go for it.
So on your weight loss journey, you were 16, you said you were already weighing 80 kg. When did you start and how long did it take you to achieve a happy medium?
Over a year.
Over a year.
Yeah.
So anyone trying to lose weight should really look at how many months to
you
be
have to
realistic.
Give yourself time.
You
have to give yourself time. You do what is realistic for you. If you're a very busy person, you know you can't even incorporate any exercise or anything, you just give yourself a safe 3 kg per month, really. So you can
lose how much a month?
You can lose as much as 4, 5, even 6 kg.
What are you doing? What are you eating?
No, you're eating foods.
Okay.
But then you're exercising, you're creating a balance. For some people, they don't have the opportunity to exercise. They don't even have the time to exercise.
Mm.
You know, they're just like, oh, let me just do what I can do. I'm a very sedentary, you know, sitting down in the office kind of person. So put yourself in a... Don't put yourself in the same time zone with those that sleep in the gym or something. You understand? Just stay in your own time zone and create your own how many kg you want to lose in a month. Mm. And that way, you won't have a heartbreak at the end of the month.
So what I loved about your book was I loved your food plan.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I go through your week one food plan, I just wanted to look at some of the things on here. So on Monday, you said you have tea with a vegetable omelet. So there's no carbohydrates there.
That's just the protein, the eggs and vegetables. You can use ugu or carrots, cabbage.
And then what I love here, there's a lot of fish pepper soup. There's goat meat pepper soup. There is, actually, you have some bread here. There's days where you can eat bread. Mm-hmm. So tell me, I mean, you're very specific about the number of akaras people can eat. So on Saturday, you can have 4 akaras and pop. When you were developing this, how did you test this menu to make sure that it worked?
Most times I test on myself. Or I have my clients have like, I want to send you a meal plan to try and tell me how many kg you lose in the week, you know. I work with so many people. Currently, I'm working with so many people online. So I can always send them out a meal plan. I'm like, I have a meal plan for you. And maybe I'm trying it out for something. And I'm like, try it and let's see how many kg you lose. I try out myself too sometimes. And let's see. Yeah, so that's it. That's how I
mean, you have 1 cup of porridge, yam, and vegetables. I mean, to be honest with you, a lot of people really try to avoid yam and carbohydrates when they're on a diet. But you're saying that you can incorporate that.
Yeah, that's the problem. You don't avoid any food group. They taught us balanced diet is every food group. Mm-hmm. Carbohydrates, protein, vitamins. So when you're exempting one, how long can you exempt for? Is it sustainable?
It's not. So now people will say, it's June. You're like, okay, you've just gingered everyone. They're ready to go. What should they start with? Like, how do you start today? Like, what are the things that I can start to do today?
What you can start today is you can do very simple exercise. Take a walk. Today's Saturday. Mm-hmm. So you can take a walk. Today, tell yourself that you're not going to have any junk. I didn't include junk in my food.
You have snacks. Yes, so let's look at the snacks you have. So you have snacks, orange and garden oranges. You have garden eggs. How do you cook the garden eggs? You just eat raw. Okay, the little garden eggs, okay. Watermelon, you have watermelon. Cucumbers, and you have ground nuts. So oranges, you have fruit. So these are your snacks.
Yes, I didn't go for doughy options because, first of all, I don't consider junk. You know, even the dictionary describes junk like rubbish. So you do not actually, you don't feed your body with stuff that is not going to help your goal, really.
What type of things would you say you tell people to avoid? Because I think that's also good for people to have a list of things to stay away from.
Very little moderation. Very little moderation. Doughy, fry. I don't want to call out because...
You don't want to call out anyone? Okay, no problem.
Because if I say small
You're not supposed
right
to avoid
now.
Anything, like you said, but just in moderation and maybe special occasions.
Yeah. I don't want to say small chores, but leave it for occasions. You don't have to have it in your house,
And so no small chops at home, but when you go out, eat small chops.
I love small chops too, but the calorie pack in one small pack of small chops is so not... friendly.
Give me a sense of how much is actually in one. Like, example.
It could be over 1,000 for the, for the 4 plates.
Yes.
Yeah. So, you see, the thing is, those are...
So, those are, like, the samosas, the egg rolls.
The complete, the plantain thing, mosa. And
so, just one pack has 1,000 calories.
Over.
Yeah,
One pack. So, that's a lot.
That packs a punch. But if that's all you eat for the day, that's not all you're going to eat.
So, you have to... I tell people that when you... Earn your treat. If that is a treat for you, earn it. Earn it. Work for it. So you
can. It takes a lot of time to burn 1,000 calories.
But you see the thing. Even as we're talking now, we're burning calories. That's a good part. But the thing is, how much are we burning? How much I'm burning is different from how much you're burning. But as we're talking, we're burning.
Okay.
So, but then it's you have to create some sort of deficit. Literally, for weight loss, there always has to be calorie deficit, whether I want to calculate it or not. So if you're not on the deficit end.
You're not gonna lose weight.
So you can't be having it every day. So if you're gonna have it on Saturday, then keep like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday really clean, really healthy, conscious. You know, I'm eating my good portions. You know, just so that, that wedding I'm going for.
So I have a question for you as a medical doctor. There's been a lot of conversations around cleansing. People do cleansing. People do cleanse fasting. All these things. You're a medical doctor. You're also a fitness enthusiast and a coach. Mm-hmm. What do you think about cleansing and using different ways of cleansing?
That's the thing. Different ways of cleansing is the problem. You see, when a patient comes in and, you know, with some particular symptoms, we ask, do you take any traditional medication? Do you take any teas? Do you take these? Because we want to know that is one of the most common causes of acute renal failure. So you see, and you know, a lot of people coming down with kidney.
You just said something that people are like, what does she mean?
Yes, so a lot of people are coming down with kidney issues.
Okay.
Acute kidney injury, you know, kidney issues. And it's because of so many things they're drinking they do not know. So my question is, what are you cleansing with? When you say cleanse, are you like using like bleach or something to clean your body? Like, I don't know, literally, what are you cleansing? If your kidneys are functioning, they are auto-regulation, they are auto-cleansers for the body. They should function. But if you're overworking it, giving it some chemicals and herbs and, you know, things, some strong things that you say, oh, this is a strong fluid, you know, that you're taking it, it's... You're doing your body more harm than really cleansing. So if you really want to cleanse, even water... Water is a very good detoxifying fluid that is underused. You realize that if you drink so much water, you tend to, it's as if you're passing out a lot more urine, and it's like with time it gets clearer.
You're
detoxifying, literally. So even water, plain water, is nobody wants to drink that. But they want to drink some mixture that looks well packaged. So if then the fasting, the thing about the fast is, it's good once in a while you like you let your liver rest and let your body rest. But how long are you fasting for? Is it now going to be harmful to you? Okay. You know, they say too much of everything is bad. So if you're fasting, how are you recovering after the fast? You understand? It's very, very important because you can be doing yourself more harm than good.
Okay. And I know it's June now, so people still have
6 months.
6 months.
To
hit your goals. So, Ariella Fitness, people can connect with you online.
Yeah.
You have a blog.
I have a website, ariellafitness.com, and all social media with Ariella Fitness.
Well, thank you so much for coming, and thank you for bringing Pounded Yam back to the diet.
Thank you.
We're going on a break on the show, morning show, but when we return, we'll be talking about Pilates. Stay tuned.